Good morning, everyone, and welcome to the 9 a.m. Hour of Power Celebration Service. So happy to have you on this beautiful day that the Lord hath made. David said, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go to the house of the Lord. Now, whether you're here in person or watching online right now, how many can put your hands together and say you're glad to be connected to the house of the Lord? Would you give him a loud praise right now? I'm glad to be connected to the house of the Lord today. I want you to look at somebody and say, you are loved. Come on, tell them, you're loved. You're loved. That's our theme today, the amazing power of God's love. Turn around and tell someone else, you're loved. Oh, my goodness. In an impersonal world, it's good to know that you're loved. And the Lord loves us, and he cares about us. How many believe he has a good plan for us? Can I hear an amen? He has a good plan. Give him another prayer. He's got a good plan. Somebody shout, he's got a good plan for me. He's got a good plan for me in my life. Would you stretch your hand out towards me? We're going to come into agreement that this service will be a special one. We're going to worship with all our mind, all our soul, all our strength, Heavenly Father. Lord, I think of that verse as we're praying and coming into agreement. When they said, Jesus, what is the greatest commandment? You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, your soul, and your mind, and all your strength. That means worship him in spirit and in truth. Give it all you've got. Then you said, love your neighbor as yourself. God, I pray we'll make a joyful noise unto the Lord today. And Father, in the name of Jesus, miracles would happen not only here, but to the many of you that are watching right now. In Jesus' name we pray. Lord, by faith we receive it, and by faith we call it done. In the name of Jesus. Praise God. Are you happy to know him? Give him one more loud hand praise right now. Oh, come on, give him a loud praise. Thank you, Jesus. Praise him, saints. Those of you watching, put your hands together. And let's make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Come on, Faith City. Can we just clap our hands all over this house?
Hallelujah.
Come on, put some clapping in your hands.
Hallelujah.
And can you add to that a shout with your voice and just magnify the God of your salvation? Somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody say thank you, Jesus. Father, we thank you for your joy and your strength.
Oh, yes, God.
And Lord, we asking God that it would rise in us this morning. Let the joy of the Lord, that is our strength, let it rise in this house. In the mighty name of Jesus, we honor you and we praise you. Come on, one more time, Faith City. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yeah, a simple song this morning. We're going to throw back a little bit. Let the glory of the Lord rise among us. Let the glory of the Lord rise among us. Let the praises of our King rise among us. Let it rise. Let the glory of the Lord rise among us. Let the glory of the Lord rise among us. Let the praises of our King rise among us. Let it rise, yeah. We sing, oh, let it rise, yeah. Hold this out, say, oh. And we cry, oh, 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 let it let it rise. Yeah, we sing, oh. Let the power of the Lord say,
let the power of the Lord
rise.
Rise among
power
us.
Of the Lord.
Let the power of the Lord rise among
praises
us.
Of our
let the praises
King.
Of our King.
Woo, yeah.
Rise among us. Let it rise.
Hey, come on. Say, let the power of let the song of the Lord say,
let the songs of the Lord
rise,
rise among
one that'll please you, Jesus.
Let the songs of the Lord
rise,
rise among
praises
us. Let the praises of our King rise among us.
Let it rise. Hey, come on, say,
let the songs of the Lord,
the songs of the Lord
rise, rise among
songs
us.
Of the Lord. I need you to clap your hands in this room. Let it rise, let it rise. Sing it again, sing. Let it rise.
Let it rise.
We want your glory, God. We want your power. We need you, Jesus. Let it rise.
Let it rise.
I need you to repeat after me. Watch me. Everybody say, let your glory,
let it rise.
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 Let your
power,
let it rise.
Let your
power,
let it rise.
Y'all still looking at us. What's wrong? Everybody clap your hands. We sing, oh, oh, let it rise.
Let it rise.
Everybody, we sing, oh, oh, let it rise, let it rise. Come on. The glory comes from out of you. Let it rise in this room. Out of your mouth shall flow rivers. Out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. Let it rise in this place.
Come on, don't you stop now. Keep the praises high in the room. Keep it high in the room. Lift up your hands. Talk to God whatever way you need to. Because we must praise him for whatever. Whether you're in a hard place right now, it could be worse. So we have to thank God. Honor, glory, and praise. Come on, let your praises rise.
Let praises rise. From the inside of me, may you delight in the inside of me, come fill my life from the inside. From the inside of me, set me on fire. From the inside, cause all I want is for you to be glorified, for you to be. All I want is for you to be glorified, for you to be lifted high.
Come on and help me.
From the inside of me, 'cause all I
for you to be glorified, for you to be lifted high. All I want is for you, for you to be glorified, you to be lifted. Come on and help me sing.
All I want
is for you,
is for you,
for you to be glorified,
you to be glorified,
we lift up your name.
Praise him, saints of God. Give him a loud praise. The scripture says, and Jesus spoke unto them and said, if I be lifted up, I will draw all men unto me. And that's what we're doing here. And many of you watching right now, we're lifting up Jesus. And in the atmosphere of praise and worship, that's where the miraculous takes place. How many today need a miracle from the Lord? Would you raise your hand? You need God intervention. That's what a miracle is. God does something that we can't do, that science cannot do. Just leave that hand up if you believe God is able to do it right now. I believe he's able. I believe he's going to do it in the name of Jesus. Give him a wave offering, Father. We're praising you right now that God is able. He's the God who is able to do it. He's the God who's moving right now. He's the God who's preparing people's hearts for the miracle right now. We decree it and we declare it in the name of Jesus. There's nothing too hard for the Lord. Last Sunday, we prayed for a pastor, Don, and his wife, Debbie. Man is a powerful man of faith, and they had to do a quadruple bypass on him. Man pastors two churches, and the devil was trying to take him out and defeat him. But we prayed. A lot of God's people prayed everywhere, and he came out on the other side of that surgery. He's on the mend. He's going to get back in the saddle before you know it. Can I hear a praise God? When you pray, it helps. When you pray, it turns it around. And you might be in that situation today. It's not looking all that good like it was for Pastor Don at the moment. But the good news is this. God has the final say on your situation. How many are glad that Dr. Jesus has the final say on it? Everybody else may have what they're going to say, but he has the final say on the matter. We're going to get ready to pray for you here and those of you that are watching today. But before we do, we want to see if we have any online requests. We have so many people that watch from all over, and we're going to see if we have any of those. We are faithful to pray for the online people. I want to ask a question as they're preparing for that, as he's coming right now. How many, by the raising of a hand, could say that in the last 12 months, God did a miracle in your life? Can you raise your hand? Can you acknowledge that right now? That God did a miracle in that. What am I doing? I'm trying to encourage you that God is in the miracle working business, and he gives miracles to people who want them, to people who go after them, people who seek them. Thank you, brother. If you'll lay those right there, praise God. Appreciate you, Brother Ernesto. Brother Harmon's not able to make it to the first service today. He'll be here later. Give Brother Ernesto a hand. He's stepping right in there. Faithful man. We appreciate him today. God bless him. But I'm here to tell you today that no matter what the doctor has told you, there's a great physician, and his name is Jesus. Well, let's see what we have that's coming online today. Here's a praise report. It says on the paper, I'm giving honor to God. I obtained a degree that I worked for so long in my life. How about a praise God for that? Pressing on through that. A brother Keith, suspected of having a serious cancer issue. He said the test came back thank God there's no cancer in my body. I don't have to go through it. Come on, give God a shout for that. You know that man's relieved today. God bless him. This is Sister Suzanne. I want to praise God miraculously for saving one of our children. And we thank God that even though the child was in ICU, it has been released and everything is all right now. How about a praise God for that? Boy, life has surprises, but God will get you through those surprises. Cora Lynn, prayers for the Parker family. Tony Bullock needs prayer. And Glorious Need and Beverly needs prayer as well. April from Pine Street. Mom Stella and Charlotte from Salem, New Jersey. I'm battling stress and I need a financial breakthrough. Rajayam, a young man, he constantly has insomnia, cannot sleep, has tormented dreams. How many believe that God can set that person free? Would you shout amen? Matter of fact, would you stretch your hand out towards it right now? I want you to shout this after me. Everybody say, devil, in the name of Jesus, you cannot have this person. You cannot destroy their life right now. In the name of Jesus, we declare miracle deliverance right now. Now raise your hand and praise God for it by faith. In the name of Jesus, the devil is a liar. Larry, pray for a severe challenge going on in my life. Stephen, praise the Lord that God will heal my family. Marilyn, pray for our housing. God will help our situation where I live. All the houses were torn down. Marilyn, if you're watching right now, God has the next house already lined up. Somebody shout amen right now. Brian, pray for my brother, bipolar disorder. William, thank God for healing my knee. Karen, I'm currently hospitalized after colon surgery. Pray for Lynn Franklin, who was in the hospital. Danielle, for Amaya and my mother. Donna, pray for my grandson. 19 years old, was hit by a car while riding his new motor scooter. He's in ICU. How many believe he's going to come out alive in the name of Jesus? Somebody's got to have the faith. Chris in Greenville, North Carolina, watching today, praying for a job and a financial blessing and deliverance from depression. Brother, come on up. He has some more requests here. Thank you, Brother Ernesto, so much. Prayers for Kajai Jackson. He lost his grandfather, and he is hurting this morning. I want you, if you would, to stretch your hands out. I want Brother Ernesto to come up and get the oil ready. I'm going to spread these out. Would you stretch your hands out, beloved, to all these requests? Somebody said, what about my miracle? I've learned over the years, if you want a miracle, help somebody else get a miracle. And watch what God will do for you. Here's a few more, brother. Oh, here's another one. Kolia, pray for my daughter, her health, and upcoming test. James Waters, who's on dialysis. They say he can't come for the treatment anymore. Something is going awry. But I want everybody to shout this after me. Come on, shout it as loud as you can. Say, devil, in the name of Jesus, we declare miracle power in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. We declare people will live and not die. We declare that God is turning it around in the name of Jesus. Father, we declare that what the devil meant for bad, God is turning it around into a miracle right now. In Jesus' name, would you raise your hand and praise God? These dear souls need encouragement today. Oh, some of them have no place to live. Some of them don't know what they're going to do. But God, we decree and declare everything is going to be all right in Jesus' name. And now for your miracle, would you stretch forth your hand? I don't care how tough it is. God specializes in turning things around. Father, I stretch forth my hand today. I'm praying against cancer in the name of Jesus. every form of cancer. Lord, we just had a brother healed of cancer here in the church, of myeloma cancer. Father, I pray the tumor will go in Jesus' name. I pray that lump on your body will dissolve in the name of Jesus. I pray for rheumatoid arthritis to be healed, delivered, and set free in Jesus' name. I pray for somebody with pancreatic cancer that the Lord will heal it right now. Liver cancer, kidney cancer. I bind it in the name of Jesus right now. Brain tumors, you've got to go in the name of Jesus. Insomnia, I bind you right now in Jesus' name. Bipolar, I take authority over you in the name of Jesus. I pray every chemical imbalance in the body will come into miracle alignment right now in the name of Jesus. And Lord, by faith we receive it, and by faith we call it done. I pray for a healing in your home. I pray for household salvation. Many of you here and many of you watching right now, that your children and your grandchildren will come into the fold of the gospel of Jesus Christ, and by faith we call it done right now. I want you to raise your hand, beloved, if you would, here and that are watching, and begin to thank God for your miracle. Come on, lift your voice and begin to say, Lord, I thank you for the miracle. Lord, I praise you for the miracle. Come on, say it loud. Somebody is getting a breakthrough right now in the name of Jesus. But you got to speak it. You got to declare it. You got to believe it. Father, we praise you for it right now in Jesus' name. Can we give him a wave offering? Lord, I feel the anointing power of God. I not only feel it here, but I feel it in somebody's apartment. I feel it in somebody's home right now. I feel we're in a turnaround moment. Somebody take your hand and turn it around right now. God is giving you a turnaround, and only God can do it. He's doing it right now. The turnaround God is giving you a miracle turnaround right now in the name of Jesus. Come on, turn it around. He's, listen, the devil said, I'm going to do this, but God said, I'm going to take it and turn it around another way. Hallelujah. I'm giving you a miracle turnaround in the name of Jesus. Speaking of miracles, let's get ready for the greatest miracle of all. John chapter 3, verse 16. Can we say that Bible verse together? Oh, what a blessing it is, to say it. Come on, read it out loud. We call it the salvation verse. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth on him should not perish, but have everlasting life. The word that stands out to me is the word whosoever. How many can raise your hand and say you were a whosoever one time? That you were a whosoever and you believed on Jesus and he saved you. How many know he'll save you if you're high, if you're messed up, if you're on drugs? He doesn't care. He wants you to call on him right now and he'll save you. I want us to pray the salvation prayer. I believe somebody's watching right now. You've got an addiction, and the devil's told you you're not worthy to call on Jesus. May I tell you the devil's title in the Bible in John chapter 8? The father of lies. Whatever he's telling you, believe the opposite. If the devil's telling you God doesn't want you, God wants you right now. He's waiting for you to call on him. So I want us to pray the salvation prayer. Let's make sure people are saved, because in the world we're living in today, how many know we better be praying for the Middle East, that God will bring peace to this world? We're living in the end times. Read Revelation and you will see that in the end time there will be wars and rumors of wars. But it said, don't be alarmed, my brothers and sisters. Look up, your redemption is drawing nigh. Are you saved? If there ever was a time to be saved, you need to be saved right now. Don't take a chance with your soul. Come on, shout this prayer with me, everybody. Say, Jesus, by faith I believe you died on the old rugged cross for all of my sins. Right now, Jesus, I'm making a decision. Hell is not for me. I want heaven to be my home. So I confess my sin. I ask for forgiveness. I ask you to wash my sin away. Come into my life and put my name in the Lamb's book of life. In Jesus' name, I call myself a child of the Most High God. Amen. How about to praise the Lord for that? Whoever meant it, whoever prayed it, God took care of it. And thank God that everything is all right. I feel led, beloved, to pray one more prayer. I want us all to say this together. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, we pray for the condition of our world today. Father, we are praying that in the last days there would be a great revival. There would be many souls coming into the kingdom. We pray for the Middle East. We pray for all that's going on in the world. We pray for Israel, the apple of God's eye, according to the scripture. Father, we put it in your hands, and we believe victory in Jesus. Amen. How about another shout right now? Friend, we're not to be worried. We're not to be afraid. We're to trust in the Almighty God. Now, before you sit down, we do this around Faith City all the time. I want you to take your hands and throw out some blessings to some folks all around you. Just let them know you're a person that likes to bless somebody. Come on, bless them, bless them. Throw out a double blessing to somebody. Those of you watching, I'm throwing you out a double blessing right now in your house, in your home, and on your family in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Can somebody give the Lord another praise God right now? Oh, we're so happy to see everybody here this morning. My goodness, what a great day to be in the house of the Lord. And we're excited to have all of you that watch faithfully online. It is a joy to be together in the name of Jesus. Well, we're getting ready to come to that point of the service, very important part of the service, where we receive the opportunity to show the Lord how much we love Him, how much we appreciate Him, and we thank God for His provision. How many by the raising of a hand could say, you thank God for everything He's given you? Can you raise your hand? How many thank God you could get up out of bed today? Are you thankful? Are you thankful? Oh, I said, are you thankful? I got a call early this morning to pray for a lady that's bedridden. Thank God you're not bedridden. Can I hear a praise the Lord today? So much to be thankful for, and sometimes the things that we take for granted. But the Bible says that everything we have comes from the Lord. Everything. Somebody say everything. Everything comes from the Lord. Your health, your strength, the job that you have, the ability to receive income, that all comes from the Lord. And the Lord says He doesn't want all of our money. He knows we have bills to pay and obligations. But He does say, I want you to put me first in your finances and in your money. How many have learned over the years, when you put God first in anything, it helps in everything, doesn't it, when you put Him first? And so He says, when it comes to your finances, here's what I'd like you to do. The Bible said in Malachi 3, verse 10, He said, I want you to honor me. And He said, I want you to bring all of the tithe into the storehouse, that there may be meat in my house. God said, my house, my work, the gospel work needs provision. And He said, I want you to do that, whether it's here or you're watching right now. And He said, if you'll do it, why don't you watch me open unto you the windows of heaven? Watch me pour you out a blessing that there shall not be room enough to receive it. And I will rebuke the devourer for your sake. When we give God 10% of that check He helped us make, the 90% that's left will go a whole lot farther, because He said, I'll do three things when you put me first in your money. He said, first of all, I'm going to pour out a blessing. I'm going to bless you. Secondly, He said, I'm going to increase you. There will not be room enough to receive it. And thirdly, He said, I will rebuke the devourer. I will protect you. Today, I want to ask you to pray about helping the church, if you would. There's a large project that is ahead of us. And we knew this project would be headed our way because the church 7 days a week is open. Not five, not two, not weekends only, but literally 7 days a week, 24 hours a day, the gospel is going out of the address called Faith City Family Church. This big project that we've got to begin to take on one part at a time, one area at a time, is, of course, our parking lots. All of the snowstorms, the blizzards over the years, all of the wear, the tear, the revivals, the events, the special days, and the thousands of souls that have rolled through these doors. How many believe if we take care of God's house, He's going to take care of your house? Can I hear a loud amen from somebody right now? You might say, well, I think I need some work, Pastor, on my driveway at home, and I need to get some sealing and a seal coat and some patches done. Listen to what I'm going to tell you. Write it down in your Bible. If you will help the house of the Lord, He's going to help your house and your house and your house and your house. Today, I'm going to ask if there might be a few folks that could join the pastor to begin this project. Going to have to take it an area at a time and then begin to discover what needs to be done. But how many know we've done a lot of things around here over the years? How many believe God will help us get this done? Can I hear a loud amen? Come on, somebody encourage the preacher right now. Hallelujah. I'm believing right now to be 15 people. 14. Said, Pastor, I know it takes resources to get this started. Let me raise my hand with you. I'll sow the $100 seed to get this off the conveyor belt and get us going. My hand's up. I'm stepping out of the boat by faith. I got to make a couple calls this week and make two appointments on it. And all I can do is walk on the water. Is there somebody else would raise up your hand and say, I'll give today $100 seed to help begin to work on the church, the parking areas. Is there a couple hands might go up? Yes, Lord, help me, ushers. There's a hand. God bless you. There's another one. Praise the Lord. And there's another one. Praise God. Thank you, sister. So yes, up there on the platform, there's another one. And I'm trying to keep my count, folks, but I might be a little off. Are we at five, ushers? We might be at five, I think. Let's see, are there a couple more? Just a couple more that'd be six, praise God. And could there be someone else? There's one of our ushers, seven, praise the Lord. Pastor, don't you get tired of these? Listen, it's part of doing the Lord's work. Remember a few years ago, we had to get all new roofs on the building. That was really something to walk through. But how many thank God He got us to the finish line? Give me an amen right now. You don't run from the devil. You run to the challenge. Might there be a couple more people? There's another usher right now. Thank the Lord. There's another sister. Praise God. And if you can't do the 100 today, could you do? There's another one. Hand went up. Well, thank God Almighty. Thank you, Jesus. Maybe you could do 50 or whatever you could do. And before I pray, I want to look. Is there another hand went up? I missed it. All right. I'm going to look in these cameras. There's a lot of folks. You can't get out to church. And we're your church. Would you do your best to help us today? I need a lot of you to say, let me do my best. And I decree and declare, like we've done a lot of big projects here over the years, how many believe we're going to make it to the finish line? Is there an amen from somebody? Hallelujah. Come on, give the Lord a shout right now. The devil is a liar. I will not run from the challenge. Now, Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray that everybody here will know, and I guess we're kind of reminded by the events, the world events that we're seeing, that Jesus is coming again. And the two things that will always remain is what we did for God and what we're doing for others. Lord, I pray that everybody will say, Pastor, praying for the church, praying for you, and I'm going to do my best today to help out. Because, yes, when everybody does their best, whether here or watching, We'll get to the finish line. In Jesus' name we pray. Thank you, Jesus. Somebody raise your hand and praise God. The devil's a liar on this. In the name of Jesus, amen and amen. I want to ask our wonderful ushers that I appreciate so much to come and put an envelope in everyone's hand. And while they're doing that, I want to look into these cameras and share with our online church family how to give your tithes and your offerings. Ushers, would you make sure everybody gets one? I'd be so grateful. I'm believing for a miracle today. Online, you can give your tithes and offerings by using text to give if you like, 302-455-2820. Or some are using the Cash App. It's all safe and secure. $FaithCityFC2, lower uppercase, doesn't matter. Or maybe you'd like to download the app, the church's app, on your Apple or Android device and give that way. Still, so many go to the website of the church, faithcitynow.com, and click donate. And to all of you that like to write your checks and send them by mail, the street address of the church is 179 Stanton Christiana Road, Newark, Delaware, 19702. To every one of you here, I want to look to every section of the sanctuary and respectfully say thank you for what you can do to help us on this. And to all of you watching, a respectful thank you as well. I'll be back in just a few moments.
Thank you.
would like to ask the ushers to prepare to come. And Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray a special prayer of dedication over the tithes and the offerings to not only share the gospel message, but to take care of the house of God, what many refer to as holy ground, the place of prayer and worship. Lord, today, not only to those that are here, we thank them so very much, but to those that are watching right now, that together we make a difference, together we reach people, together we get it done for the Master Jesus Christ. So we dedicate all of this today in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen and amen. Praise the Lord. Thank you, ushers. As you take your time, we appreciate you so very, very much. And while they're doing that, to those that are watching, if you'd like to connect with us, you'd like information on the church, or you might want to join, or you have a prayer request, you can connect with us by simply texting that word connect to 302-214-5773. Just because you're not able to be here in person doesn't mean we can't walk this life together in faith. You can use the QR code as well. And I'm going to ask our ushers to help me in just a moment again about a very special event that has to do with housing in our community. But while they're getting ready to do that, I invite you to join me every Wednesday from 7 to 7:30 for the virtual Bible study. I'm sitting at my desk. It's 30 minutes of the Word of the Lord. And our theme for April is the habits of happiness. That's our theme. This Wednesday, the 17th, our topic, how to be happy no matter what's going on in your life. And we're very excited about Saturday, May 4th, just around the corner, 9 a.m. to 1 p.m., an organization by the name of NACA, which stands for the Neighborhood Assistance Corporation of America, a national nonprofit community home ownership and advocacy organization in cooperation with this ministry, is presenting the Home Buyer Workshop. NACA is the largest HUD-certified organization in America helping people to become homeowners. Now, listen to this. NACA's home ownership opportunities require no down payment, no closing costs, no fees, below market fixed rates, and no perfect credit needed. I want the ushers to come, if they would, to the front. And if you'd like more than one flyer, they're happy to give you one. But listen, I believe God can take you from renting to owning your own place. This could be a door that you might want to walk through. So please take this special invitation. Take more for your family and friends. Saturday, May 4th, it is 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. right here at Faith City Family Church. And I believe it's going to be a great day of empowerment, a day to remember. And as our precious ushers are serving you, I want to make an announcement about Reach Gospel Radio, and they'll be helping me again in just a moment. But Reach Gospel Radio has been blessed to win, not over the years, one stellar award, but to God be the glory, nationally recognized. The Reach Gospel Radio has won two stellar awards. And so we're in the running, can you believe it, for our third stellar award. Isn't that God is amazing? And so I'm asking our ushers, if they would, they're so busy today, but they're doing a great job, to bring these other little flyers, I'll call them, to the front rows of the church. And if you would, ushers, to come up front and begin to pass them out. Folks, we want to ask you, if you would, to vote for Reach Gospel Radio. Many of you listen to it, and would you take this little information paper? You can use the QR code, and we only have, listen, till the 17th to be able, I believe, to vote. And I'm looking on here. Does it say it on here? Vote, yeah, now through the 17th. And so if you could make sure you vote for us, take a screenshot of it and share it with your family and friends. They can vote as well. You never know what God may do. He may give us another year of amazing favor as one of America's favorite gospel music radio networks. And don't forget, baptism is coming the 28th of April. If you'd like to be baptized and Holy Communion as well, just bring a towel and a change of clothes. So we're just excited about what God is doing here at the ministry, and we cannot do it without you. Our theme for today, and I love this theme, the amazing power of God's love. Some of you may remember that old hymn of the church. I remember it. When nothing else could help, love lifted me. How many have ever felt the power of God's love in your life? How many ever felt the power of love from another human being? Somebody, they didn't have to love you. They didn't have to go the extra mile. But because of the power of God's love, your life was changed. Our message today, the amazing power of God's love. Now, towards the end of the message, I've got something special I'm going to share. But ushers, could you help me one more time? Because I think I might see a few visitors here today, and I could be wrong. But musicians, as you continue to play, I'd like to ask at the early service this morning, if you're visiting the church, would you be so kind as to raise up your hand right now if you're visiting? As you continue to play, brothers, I request it. I'd be very grateful. Could you give me some music? Thank you so much. If you're a visitor, would you right there? I thought I saw a new face over there. Would you raise your hand if you would? Anyone else? Every visitor here, if it's just one, means the world to us. We're honored to have you. So I would like, if you raised your hand, would you stand to your feet right now? We want to give you a big hand today. Well, come on, would you give our dear friend up here? I'm going to get to know her after the service. Praise the Lord. Amen. Give her a big praise the Lord. We want her to come back. Amen. That is so awesome. Thank you. And dear, if you fill out that card while I'm preaching, and I'll be in the back. We have free refreshments and our ministry tables back there. Give me that card. Present it to me completely filled out, and we have a gift for you today. Our theme, the amazing power of God's love, and our message today is entitled, The Amazing Power of God's Love. Let God love through you. I have a question. How many believe that God has some people he wants to love on through your life? Can I hear a loud amen from someone? God wants to use you to say that one word, to do that act of kindness. Or somebody may think they have no value. They may not want to live anymore. But God uses you to change their life. Our opening verse for the message today, the amazing power of God's love, let God love through you, is out of Matthew chapter 22, beginning with verse 36. Which is the most important command? Jesus replied. Well, he said, love the Lord your God with all your heart, soul, and mind. This is the first and greatest commandment. The second most important is similar. Love your neighbor as much as you love yourself. When we open up the pages of the Bible, did you know that the Word of God says that there are three laws of love in the Bible? Thank you so much, musicians, for your ministry. We appreciate it. And what are these three laws of love in the Bible? Well, let's look at law number one. It says that the best use of life is love. In other words, if you're going to make life count, don't be just self-focused, but be others-focused. And the Bible says that when we say yes to law number one, the best use of life is love. Well, why is that so important? The Bible says love validates my faith. There are a lot of people, they may shout, they may, praise God, and that's all important. We believe in that. But the Bible says that love validates my faith if I'm really what I say I am. In 1 John chapter 4, verse 8, it says, whoever does not love does not know God, because God is love. When somebody's hurting out in the community, in the world, it's the power of God's love that's going to grab their attention. Not how loud we preach, not how many times we run around the church, and that's all great and that's fine. But when you love somebody unconditionally, how many believe it's powerful when you love somebody that nobody else wants to love? It validates the faith. 1 John 4:8. Here's another verse on love validates my faith. 1 John 4:20. If we say we love God but hate others, we are liars. For we cannot love God, whom we have not seen, if we do not love others whom we have seen. The more we love, the brighter our light shines. We're talking about the first law of love. The best use of life is love. Love validates my faith. Next of all, love integrates my life. Love, God's love brings people together. You see, when somebody has the real love of God, now people know how to charade it. People know how to do church. Many of us have been raised up in church, and we get all that, and the charade goes on. But when it's real love from God, unconditional love, it brings people together. How many know that Satan has come to divide us? He wants to divide us. He wants us to hate one another. He doesn't want us working together. But the Bible says in Colossians chapter 3, verse 14, love can bring people together. Love is more important than anything else. Colossians 3, 14. It's more important than anything else. It is what ties everything completely together. Oh, there's nothing like the power of God's love. The God kind of love will bring people together in the toughest of times. It will make walls come down. Division will go. But sometimes you got to mark those. The Bible said in Mark the 17th chapter, it says, mark those among you who cause rifts and divisions. We pray for them, but we don't have to be a part of that, do we? I want to look at somebody and say, let's work together. Come on, look over somebody and say, let's work together. That's the God kind of love. The best use of life is love. Love validates my faith. Love integrates my life. And see, love compensates for sin. Some of you maybe never heard that, but the God kind of love doesn't condemn people into hell. I've heard some preachers over the years, I'm sure they meant well. They meant well, but they were so hard. They had mercy on no one. I guess because I've been doing outreach for so long, when somebody is broke down, somebody is messed up, somebody is addicted, they don't need Pastor Hare to come along and tell them how sinful they are and how bad they are. They already know their life is a mess. They need some love from God. 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 8, love compensates for sin. Most important of all, continue to show deep love for each other. Now, I want us to read the next part out loud, these handful of words for love. Ready? For love covers a what? A multitude of sin. That doesn't mean we condone the sin, but it means we're patient with people. When somebody who has an addiction, they go back again, and they stumble again, and they go back to the same situation. We don't throw them into the trash can of life, but rather we love them, and we hang in there with them, and we pray for them, because except for the grace of God, it could be you or me in that condition. Colossians chapter 2, verse 14, about love compensates for sin. God wiped out the charges that were against us for disobeying his law. He took them away and he nailed them all to the cross. How many are glad today we're not perfect, but we're forgiven? Can I hear an amen? And we're talking about the best use of life is love. Love validates my faith. It integrates my life. It brings people together. It compensates for. It has patience with people as they're in their time of recovery in their life. And then love reverberates forever. I've done hundreds of homegoing services, every age, every circumstance, lives taken out immediately through violence. I've done funerals where the casket is only that long. I'm telling you, the thing that lasts forever, the thing that people remember is the power of love. Love. Why do we believe this? 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 13 says that love reverberates forever. Of all the things that will last when you're gone is how you love God and you love people. Three things, let's read, will continue forever. All right, what are they? The Bible said faith is one. That'll continue forever. Hope will continue forever. And love will continue forever. Now, some might have thought that faith would have been the greatest, but it says the greatest of these three is what? Shout it to me. It's love. Love reverberates forever. In the same chapter, 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse number 3, it says, no matter what I say, what I believe, and what I do, I'm bankrupt without love. Though I speak with the tongues of men and angels, though I prophesy, though I give my body to be burned. Read that whole chapter of 1 Corinthians chapter 13. It says all of that means nothing if I don't have the love of God in my heart for someone else. The three laws of love. Law number one, the best use of life is love. Love validates my faith, integrates my life, compensates for sin, reverberates forever. And the second law of love says the best expression of love is time. Real love will take and make an investment of time. Time to show up. Time to cancel what I wanted to do, to rearrange it and get involved in the pain, in the drama, in the mess of somebody's life. How many really honest Christians today could thank God for that school teacher, for that mentor, for that friend, for that church member? They got involved and helped you out. Can you raise your hand? They didn't have to help you out. You didn't give them any money for helping you out. They just wanted to help you out. They invested in you. And when that person goes on in the afterlife, how many know you remember people like that when they're gone? Because it's like, they taught me how to read. They took some time with me. They didn't have to do it. And others didn't want to fool with me. But they said, you matter. And I'm going to make an investment in you. Real love will take an investment of time. Time to show I care. Time to get involved. To help someone along life's way. Now, what does the Bible say about that? 1 John chapter 3, verse 18. We must show love through actions that are sincere, not through empty words. That's why sometimes the church at large can be a little bit unpopular or ineffective, because, you know, the world sometimes may feel that we really don't love them. We don't care. We're too busy shaking down their sins and the imperfections. But how many know if somebody has a lot of hell in their life, sometimes you just got to keep loving until you love it all out of them. Come on, say amen right now. How many would raise up a hand and say, you're glad somebody worked with you, loved you, hung in there with you when others thought there was no way you were going to have a future? Not only did God help you, but God sent people to help you. Galatians chapter 5, verse 6, the only thing that counts is faith expressing itself through love. Lining these verses up, Ephesians chapter 5, verse 2, live a life filled with love for others, following the example of Christ who loved you and gave himself as a sacrifice to take away your sins. Jesus said, all I'm asking you to do is do what I did. Jesus said, I loved you when you were a mess. I loved you when you did the same thing five times in a row. I loved you when you acted ashamed, Mama. You don't want anybody to know you were one of those Christians. I kept on loving you unconditionally 24/7 because that's just how he does it. And how many believe when you just keep on loving, love always wins? Come on, talk to me. I said it always wins. It might take a year, it might take a decade, but I'm here to tell you love will win in the end. Keep loving that child. Keep loving that grandchild. Keep loving that person. Keep working with that young person that is really going through a struggle right now. Don't give up on anybody. Because everybody has hope because of Jesus. Our sermon here today, our message, the amazing power of God's love, let God love through you. We're discovering today the three laws of love in the Bible. Law number one, the best use of life is love. Love validates my faith. Love integrates my life to help bring people together. Love compensates for sin and mistakes. It keeps on loving. Love reverberates forever. It really never dies. The second law of love is, it says, the best expression of love is when I give my time. You matter not only to God, but you matter to me. And if you want God to know that you love him, it helps when you give your time to the Lord. Come on, say amen, somebody. When you give your time to him, others never have time to give their time to the Lord, but you love him so much. God, I'm going to give my time. I'm going to change my schedule, Lord. I want to build your kingdom. And then law number three says this, the best time to love. Thank you, Brother Ron. I appreciate it. Amen. Now, I'm going to go back to my point here. The best time to love is now. The best time is to not say someday I'm going to give her a call. Someday I'm going to call him up. I want to encourage him. Someday I'll send a card in the mail. But the best time to love, somebody shout, now. Come on, say love right now. The best time to love is now. Now, the reason I'm so aggressive on that point is because of what the Bible says. Galatians chapter 6, verse 10, whenever we have the opportunity, we should do good to everyone. Sometimes people will keep putting off, well, I know I should do that. I know I should pick up the phone. I know, and all that kind of thing. But the best time to love when God puts it on your heart is right now. Ephesians 5:16, use every chance you have for doing good. Proverbs chapter 3, verse 27 and 28, whenever you possibly can, do good to those who need it. Never tell your neighbors, wait until tomorrow, if you have the ability to help them right now. 1 Corinthians chapter 14, verse 1, eagerly pursue and seek to acquiring love. Make it your aim, your great quest. The best time to love is when somebody talked to me. The best time to love is now. I'll never forget, it was years ago, I was asked to preach a funeral, and many of you know where this is, in Newport, Delaware, the little town of Newport. There's one funeral home there. And I think the name has changed, but somehow I got the time a little mixed up, so I was there an hour early. Didn't realize it. And I pulled up. Of course, I didn't see many cars. I'm thinking, well, okay. So I go in there so I can meet with the undertaker and so forth and so on. And when I go in there, no one is at least in there. Maybe a couple of the workers were upstairs or downstairs or something. But no one but me, it seemed like, was in that funeral home. And I looked in the room, and there was the person that was laying there. But there was a young lady talking to the older lady in the casket. And I'll never forget it because nobody was. So I just stood there and watched. And it's like, wow, she's having a serious conversation with this person. And I just listened, and she began to open up. She began to cry. And she looked down into that casket. And she began to say this. And then finally, I figured out, I connected the dots, what it was. she at the end, she said, "And Mom, I know I should have called you. I know I hadn't talked to you for a long, long time." And she wept and she cried, and it seemed like she could not be consoled. And she walked out the door. I couldn't get to her in time, and she left before the funeral ever happened. And the relatives told me later, saying, yeah, that was her one and only daughter. She had a son, she had a daughter, and the daughter ignored her for years, broke her mother's heart. And I learned something. You better tell mother you love her while you can. You better love while you can. Like the third law of love is, the best time to love is now. Yeah, but she hurt my feelings. Yeah, but she did this. You know what? Sometimes we need to get over ourselves. Is there two amens from someone? We need to get over our hurt feelings, because, you know, I watched her when, as she left that funeral home, she seemed like she was just had the weight of the world, and I'm sure that she did, because I'm sure the devil tried to torment her. All you had to do was call your mother. Could you let her know? Matter of fact, I found out later on, the mom didn't know where she was. She had just run off and didn't know she was dead or alive. Went to her grave not knowing if her daughter was alive. I'm here to tell you, the time to love is right now. Right now. How many, by the raising of a hand, could say, you know, I got some people I think I need to love on. Come on, raise your hand up. Let the devil see it. I said, let the devil see it. Brother Robert, we could do some music. I appreciate it right now. It just raised that hand up. Yeah, God is right now talking to you. Yes. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Look at all these hands. God is speaking to hearts today, saying the time to love is right now. Oh, keep that hand up. He's going to give you the grace. He's going to give you the words. Maybe might be somebody you haven't talked to in a decade, but the time to love is now. Call him anyway. Eat humble pie. Yeah, well, I told him I'd never talk to him again for what they did to me or what they did to my child. If God says to reach out, you better reach out before it's too late. He might use your reach out to get their soul saved. He might have you to talk to them, because in a matter of days, they could breathe their last breath. And God wanted you to talk to them before they left. Oh, let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, I just want to thank you right now, Lord, that loving really isn't that hard to do. It's not really that hard to tell somebody that, hey, I'm sorry I haven't talked to you in a while. Just want to tell you that I care about you, that I love you. And even though they might say some things that may not be all that kind, we've got the peace in our hearts that we did the right thing, that we did the God thing, that we did what the Lord wanted us to do. Lord, right now, I pray for relationships that have been strained. If you're going through a strained relationship, just raise up your hand. And many of you watching, maybe you haven't talked to that loved one, that sister, that brother, that family member. God, we pray about strained relationships. It happens in every family. But God, you're bigger than that strained relationship. Yes, the three laws of love. The best use of your life is to love people. The best expression of love is to give some time, and the best time to love is right now. So God, give us all the grace and the strength to do it. In Jesus' name we pray. Oh, thank you, Jesus. When nothing else could help, love lifted me. I was sinking deep in sin, the song said, far from the peaceful shore, very deeply stained within, sinking to rise no more. But what happened? But the master of the sea heard my despairing cry. From those deep waters lifted me. Now safe am I. Love lifted me. How many, by the raising of a hand, could say, you're so glad that love lifted you today? Come on, give the Lord a praise right now. Somebody wave your hand and give God a praise right now. Father, we want to thank you for it in the name of Jesus. When nothing else could help, yes, it was love that lifted me. Oh, yes, Jesus. As Brother Robert's playing that old hymn, I haven't heard that one in a while. when nothing else could help, it was love that lifted me. Now, before we go, saints, I know I announced, I think it was four Sundays ago, ushers, if you might get ready to help me just one more time, ushers, if you could. I announced about 4 weeks ago that God had given, opened up a door. We were able to get FCC approval. This is a miracle, with a limited time to do it, to expand the coverage of the Reach Gospel Radio Network by 1.5 million, not 150,000, but 1.5 million more people to come under the coverage of Reach Gospel Radio. How many know that's a miracle? Can I hear an amen? That is nothing but a miracle. And listen, we're living in the last days. We need to reach people while we can. And I said, in order to get this equipment and get this upgrade and the HD transmitters and all that's required in today's technology, I said we needed 125 people who would make a pledge. And we're not receiving an offering. We already did that. We took care of that earlier. But would make a faith pledge of $50 a month for 12 months to help us, because we're running out of time. This is the final Sunday that we have to do this, because we have to do it by a certain amount of time or we'll lose the permit to do it. Well, Sister Angela, one of the church secretaries, I said, revisit all the numbers. And here's where we are. Out of 125 needed, we only need 20 more. Can we give God a praise? I said, we only need 20 more people, 20 more people to get this done. Now, this is the final Sunday, and I wanted to know if we could see a miracle happen in the, now remember, this is not giving anything. This is a faith pledge of $50 a month for 12 months. And for those that do that, I felt in my heart to put something together to say thank you to all of you that do that by faith. We're going to have a thank you dinner on Sunday, April 21. That's next Sunday, a big catered dinner here on the lower level of the church. I mean, all the trim is going to be great, great fellowship. And then we're going to reserve you seats. People are coming from the four-state region to see this lady, Leandria Johnson. I've never seen, it's been years since I've seen advanced response this strong. And I've been at this a minute now. But how many believe God could give us a miracle today? Just 20 left to go. And we really need to do it today. It's a pledge. So I want to ask the ushers to come up to the front, my blessed ushers, if they would. And would somebody raise up, and when you raise up your hand, Leonard's going to change that 20 to 19. I'm believing that we can do it today. 1.5 million more souls. Would you raise up your hand right now and say, you know, I'll help. I know the Lord's coming back soon, Pastor. There's a hand. There's another hand. We're down to 18. God, well, I'm believing that today we're going to get it done. Hallelujah. Yes. Is there another hand? It's a pledge every month. You just fill out this card. They have a pen for you. But to think we can, there's another hand. There's another one, Leonard. Praise God. Amen. Might there be one more before we get ready for the benediction here? I know the devil done want 1.5 million more people. When Brother Dan told me this, I almost fell out of my chair. I said, you mean us? We're approved? He said, yeah, but you're going to have to raise some money, and we got to get HD equipment. I said, bring it on. You know me. I'll jump out of the boat and walk on some water. Is there one more? He'll get us to 15, and then we'll do it there in the back. Can we get God a shout right now? We're down to 15. Praise the Lord. I said, praise the Lord. Brother Williams, you pray for me. That today we're going to get it done. Now, those of you watching online, you can do it too. They're going to bring up on the screen right now how to do it online. You go to reachgospelradio.com. I pray Brother Leno will be able to put that up on the screen for you, that you can help us reach that goal today. Yes, there it is. So, beloved, can we stand to our feet? I see Sister April's got these delicious free refreshments ready for us. I see that our special visitor, I'm sure she got her card filled out. I got a gift for her today at the early service. And when you go in the back, if you should desire to say, I would like to join the church. When you do, we'll present you, I'll present you on that special Sunday with this beautiful certificate, and it enables you to be able to be an honored member here of Faith City Family Church. You want information? You can go to the visitors or membership table. You want to be baptized? You go right to that baptism table and they'll take care of you. Would you stretch your hand out towards me right now? Oh, I'm so thankful that you came today. So grateful. And remember, the time to love is now. I've been at this a minute. Listen, God will get you through hassles with people, headaches, foolishness going on that you shouldn't be dealing with. Just keep your heart right and love through it, and God will put it all together. So now I'm praying, as your hand is stretched out to me, I'm praying that you're going to love like you never loved. I pray you're going to call somebody, send a card as the Lord puts it on your heart, and as you do it, you're going to be blessed. So now may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you. May the Lord lift up his countenance on you and give you his peace. In the name of God the Father, Jesus the Son, and the Comforter who is the Holy Spirit, I pray you'll be blessed in your coming in, and as the Bible says, as you're going out, I pray you'll have tremendous favor this week, that doors will open that no man can shut, and whatever resources you need, God will not only provide them, but he'll do it in abundance. In the name of God the Father, Jesus the Son, and the Comforter who is the Holy Spirit. Amen, amen, and amen. How about a loud praise to the Lord right now? Beloved, I'm in the back. We're back here to take your visitor card, your pledge cards, and fellowship with refreshments. Good morning, everyone, and welcome to the 9 a.m. Hour of Power Celebration Service. So happy to have you on this beautiful day that the Lord hath made. David said, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go to the house of the Lord. Now, whether you're here in person or watching online right now, how many can put your hands together and say, you're glad to be connected to the house of the Lord? Would you give him a loud praise right now? I'm glad to be connected to the house of the Lord today. I want you to look at somebody and say, you are loved. Come on, tell them, you're loved. You're loved. That's our theme today, the amazing power of God's love. Turn around and tell someone else, you're loved. Oh, my goodness. In an impersonal world, it's good to know that you're loved. And the Lord loves us, and he cares about us. How many believe he has a good plan for us? Can I hear an amen? He has a good plan. Give him another prayer. He's got a good plan. Somebody shout, he's got a good plan for me. He's got a good plan for me in my life. Would you stretch your hand out towards me? We're going to come into agreement that this service will be a special one. We're going to worship with all our mind, all our soul, all our strength, Heavenly Father. Lord, I think of that verse as we're praying and coming into agreement. When they said, Jesus, what is the greatest commandment? You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, your soul, and your mind, and all your strength. That means worship him in spirit and in truth. Give it all you've got. Then you said, love your neighbor as yourself. God, I pray we'll make a joyful noise unto the Lord today. And Father, in the name of Jesus, miracles would happen not only here, but to the many of you that are watching right now. In Jesus' name we pray. Lord, by faith we receive it, and by faith we call it done. In the name of Jesus. Praise God. Are you happy to know him? Give him one more loud hand praise right now. Oh, come on, give him a loud praise. Thank you, Jesus. Praise him, saints. Those of you watching, put your hands together. And let's make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, yes, Faith City. Can we just clap our hands all over Hallelujah. This house? Hallelujah. Come on, put some clapping in your hands. Hallelujah. And can you add to that a shout with your voice Hallelujah. And just magnify the God of your salvation? Somebody Hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. Somebody say thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Father, we thank you for your joy and your strength.
Oh, yes, God.
And Lord, we asking God that it would rise in us this morning. Let the joy of the Lord, that is our strength, let it rise in this house. In the mighty name of Jesus, we honor you and we praise you. Come on, one more time, Faith City. Somebody shout hallelujah. Yeah, a simple song this morning. We're going to throw back a little bit. Let the glory of the Lord rise among us. Let the glory of the Lord rise among us. Let the praises of our King rise among us. Let it rise. Yeah, yeah. Yeah. Let the glory of the Lord rise among us. Let the glory of the Lord rise among us. Let the praises of our King rise among us. Let it rise, yeah. We sing, oh, let it rise, yeah. Hold this out, say, oh. And we cry, oh, 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 let it rise. Somebody sing, let it ride.
Let it ride.
Hey, clap your hands in this room. Hey, let the power of the Lord say.
Let the power of the Lord
rise.
Rise among
us. Power of the Lord.
Let the power of the Lord rise among
us. Praises of our King.
Praises of our King.
Woo, yeah.
Rise among us. Let it rise.
Hey, come on. Say, let the power of one more. Let the song of the Lord say.
Let the songs of the Lord
rise.
Rise among
one that'll please
let the
Jesus.
Songs of the Lord
rise.
Rise among
praises
us. Let the praises of our King rise among us.
Let it rise. Hey, come on, say it. Let the songs of the Lord.
Let the songs of the Lord
rise.
Rise among
songs
us.
Of the Lord. I need you to clap your hands in this room. Let it rise, let it rise. I need you to repeat after me. Watch me. Everybody say, let your glory,
let it
rise.
Let your glory,
let it rise.
Let your glory,
let it rise.
Let your glory,
let it rise.
Let your
power,
let it rise.
Let your
power,
let it rise.
Let it
rise.
Let your
deliverance.
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 We need it. Looking at us, what's wrong? Everybody clap your hands. We sing, oh, 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 let it rise.
Let it rise.
Everybody, we sing, oh, 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 let it rise, let it rise. Room. Come on. The glory comes from out of you. Let it rise in this room. Out of your mouth shall flow rivers. Out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. Let it rise in this place.
Come on, don't you stop now. Keep the praises high in the room. Keep it high in the room. Lift up your hands, talk to God whatever way you need to. Because we must praise him for whatever. Whether you're in a hard place right now, it could be worse. So we have to thank God. Honor, glory, and praise. Come on, let your praises rise.
Let praises rise. From the inside, from the inside of me, may you delight in the inside, in the inside of me. Come fill my life from the inside. From the inside of me, set me on fire. From the inside, cause all I want is for you to be glorified, for you to be. All I want is for you to be glorified, for you to be lifted high. Come on and help me.
Cause all I want.
lift up your name. Cause all I want is for you to be glorified, for you to be lifted high. All I want is for you to be glorified, you to be lifted. Come on and help me sing.
All I want is for you.
Praise him, saints of God. Give him a loud praise. The scripture says, and Jesus spoke unto them and said, if I be lifted up, I will draw all men unto me. And that's what we're doing here. And many of you watching right now, we're lifting up Jesus. And in the atmosphere of praise and worship, that's where the miraculous takes place. How many today need a miracle from the Lord? Would you raise your hand? You need God intervention. That's what a miracle is. God does something that we can't do, that science cannot do. Just leave that hand up if you believe God is able to do it right now. I believe he's able. I believe he's going to do it in the name of Jesus. Give him a wave offering. Father, we're praising you right now that God is able. He's the God who is able to do it. He's the God who's moving right now. He's the God who's preparing people's hearts for the miracle right now. We decree it and we declare it in the name of Jesus. There's nothing too hard for the Lord. Last Sunday, we prayed for a pastor, Don, and his wife, Debbie. Man is a powerful man of faith, and they had to do a quadruple bypass on him. Man pastors two churches, and the devil was trying to take him out and defeat him. But we prayed. A lot of God's people prayed everywhere, and he came out on the other side of that surgery. He's on the mend. He's going to get back in the saddle before you know it. Can I hear a praise God? When you pray, it helps. When you pray, it turns it around. And you might be in that situation today. It's not looking all that good like it was for Pastor Don at the moment. But the good news is this. God has the final say on your situation. How many are glad that Dr. Jesus has the final say on it? Everybody else may have what they're going to say, but he has the final say on the matter. We're going to get ready to pray for you here and those of you that are watching today. But before we do, we want to see if we have any online requests. We have so many people that watch from all over, and we're going to see if we have any of those. We are faithful to pray for the online people. I want to ask a question as they're preparing for that, as he's coming right now. How many, by the raising of a hand, could say that in the last 12 months, God did a miracle in your life? Can you raise your hand? Can you acknowledge that right now? That God did a miracle in that. What am I doing? I'm trying to encourage you that God is in the miracle working business, and he gives miracles to people who want them, to people who go after them, people who seek them. Thank you, brother. If you'll lay those right there, praise God. Appreciate you, Brother Ernesto. Brother Harmon's not able to make it to the first service today. He'll be here later. Give Brother Ernesto a hand. He's stepping right in there. Faithful man. We appreciate him today. God bless him. But I'm here to tell you today that no matter what the doctor has told you, there's a great physician, and his name is Jesus. Let's see what we have that's coming online today. Here's a praise report. It says on the paper, I'm giving honor to God. I obtained a degree that I worked for so long in my life. How about a praise God for that? Pressing on through that. A brother Keith, suspected of having a serious cancer issue. He said the test came back. Thank God there's no cancer in my body. I don't have to go through it. Come on, give God a shout for that. You know that man's relieved today. God bless him. This is Sister Suzanne. I want to praise God miraculously for saving one of our children. And we thank God that even though the child was in ICU, it has been released and everything is all right now. How about a praise God for that? Boy, life has surprises, but God will get you through those surprises. Cora Lynn, prayers for the Parker family. Tony Bullock needs prayer. And Gloria Sneed and Beverly needs prayer as well. April from Pine Street. Mom Stella and Charlotte from Salem, New Jersey. I'm battling stress and I need a financial breakthrough. Rajayam, a young man, he constantly has insomnia, cannot sleep, has tormentive dreams. How many believe that God can set that person free? Would you shout amen? Matter of fact, would you stretch your hand out towards it right now? I want you to shout this after me. Everybody say, devil, in the name of Jesus, you cannot have this person. You cannot destroy their life right now. In the name of Jesus, we declare miracle deliverance right now. Now raise your hand and praise God for it by faith. In the name of Jesus, the devil is a liar. Larry, pray for a severe challenge going on in my life. Stephen, praise the Lord that God will heal my family. Marilyn, pray for our housing. God will help our situation where I live. All the houses were torn down. Marilyn, if you're watching right now, God has the next house already lined up. Somebody shout amen right now. Brian, pray for my brother, bipolar disorder. William, thank God for healing my knee. Karen, I'm currently hospitalized after colon surgery. Pray for Lynn Franklin, who was in the hospital. Danielle, for Amaya and my mother. Donna, pray for my grandson. 19 years old, was hit by a car while riding his new motor scooter. He's in ICU. How many believe he's going to come out alive in the name of Jesus? Somebody's got to have the faith. Chris in Greenville, North Carolina, watching today, praying for a job and a financial blessing and deliverance from depression. Brother, come on up. He has some more requests here. Thank you, Brother Ernesto, so much. Prayers for Kajai Jackson. He lost his grandfather, and he is hurting this morning. I want you, if you would, to stretch your hands out. I want Brother Ernesto to come up and get the oil ready. I'm going to spread these out. Would you stretch your hands out, beloved, to all these requests? Somebody said, what about my miracle? I've learned over the years, if you want a miracle, help somebody else get a miracle. And watch what God will do for you. Here's a few more, brother. Oh, here's another one. Kolia, pray for my daughter, her health, and upcoming test. James Waters, who's on dialysis. They say he can't come for the treatment anymore. Something is going awry. But I want everybody to shout this after me. Come on, shout it as loud as you can. Say, devil, in the name of Jesus, we declare miracle power in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. We declare people will live and not die. We declare that God is turning it around in the name of Jesus. Father, we declare that what the devil meant for bad, God is turning it around into a miracle right now. In Jesus' name, would you raise your hand and praise God? These dear souls need encouragement today. Oh, some of them have no place to live. Some of them don't know what they're going to do. But God, we decree and declare everything is going to be all right. In Jesus' name. And now for your miracle, would you stretch forth your hand? I don't care how tough it is. God specializes in turning things around. Father, I stretch forth my hand today. I'm praying against cancer in the name of Jesus. every form of cancer. Lord, we just had a brother healed of cancer here in the church, of myeloma cancer. Father, I pray the tumor will go in Jesus' name. I pray that lump on your body will dissolve in the name of Jesus. I pray for rheumatoid arthritis to be healed, delivered, and set free in Jesus' name. I pray for somebody with pancreatic cancer that the Lord will heal it right now. Liver cancer, kidney cancer. I bind it in the name of Jesus right now. Brain tumors, you've got to go in the name of Jesus. Insomnia, I bind you right now in Jesus' name. Bipolar, I take authority over you in the name of Jesus. I pray every chemical imbalance in the body will come into miracle alignment right now in the name of Jesus. And Lord, by faith we receive it, and by faith we call it done. I pray for a healing in your home. I pray for household salvation. Many of you here and many of you watching right now, that your children and your grandchildren will come into the fold of the gospel of Jesus Christ, and by faith we call it done right now. I want you to raise your hand, beloved, if you would, here and that are watching, and begin to thank God for your miracle. Come on, lift your voice and begin to say, Lord, I thank you for the miracle. Lord, I praise you for the miracle. Come on, say it loud. Somebody is getting a breakthrough right now in the name of Jesus, but you got to speak it. You got to declare it. You got to believe it. Father, we praise you for it right now in Jesus' name. Can we give him a wave offering? Lord, I feel the anointing power of God. I not only feel it here, but I feel it in somebody's apartment. I feel it in somebody's home right now. I feel we're in a turnaround moment. Somebody take your hand and turn it around right now. God is giving you a turnaround. And only God can do it. He's doing it right now. The turnaround God is giving you a miracle turnaround right now in the name of Jesus. Come on, turn it around. Listen, the devil said, I'm going to do this, but God said, I'm going to take it and turn it around another way. Hallelujah. I'm giving you a miracle turnaround in the name of Jesus. Speaking of miracles, let's get ready for the greatest miracle of all. John chapter 3, verse 16. Can we say that Bible verse together? Oh, what a blessing it is, a blessing it is to say it. Come on, read it out loud. We call it the salvation verse. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth on him should not perish, but have everlasting life. The word that stands out to me is the word whosoever. How many can raise your hand and say you were a whosoever one time, that you were a whosoever and you believed on Jesus and he saved you? How many know he'll save you if you're high, if you're messed up, if you're on drugs? He doesn't care. He wants you to call on him right now and he'll save you. I want us to pray the salvation prayer. I believe somebody's watching right now. You've got an addiction, and the devil's told you you're not worthy to call on Jesus. May I tell you the devil's title in the Bible in John chapter 8? The father of lies. Whatever he's telling you, believe the opposite. If the devil's telling you God doesn't want you, God wants you right now. He's waiting for you to call on him. So I want us to pray the salvation prayer. Let's make sure people are saved, because in the world we're living in today, how many know we better be praying for the Middle East, that God will bring peace to this world? We're living in the end times. Read Revelation and you will see that in the end time there will be wars and rumors of wars. But it said, don't be alarmed, my brothers and sisters. Look up, your redemption is drawing nigh. Are you saved? If there ever was a time to be saved, you need to be saved right now. Don't take a chance with your soul. Come on, shout this prayer with me, everybody. Say, Jesus, by faith I believe you died on the old rugged cross for all of my sins. Right now, Jesus, I'm making a decision. Hell is not for me. I want heaven to be my home. So I confess my sin. I ask for forgiveness. I ask you to wash my sin away. Come into my life and put my name in the Lamb's book of life. In Jesus' name, I call myself a child of the Most High God. Amen. How about to praise the Lord for that? Whoever meant it, whoever prayed it, God took care of it. And thank God that everything is all right. I feel led, beloved, to pray one more prayer. I want us all to say this together. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, we pray for the condition of our world today. Father, we are praying that in the last days there would be a great revival. There would be many souls coming into the kingdom. We pray for the Middle East. We pray for all that's going on in the world. We pray for Israel, the apple of God's eye, according to the scripture. Father, we put it in your hands, and we believe victory in Jesus. Amen. How about another shout right now? Friend, we're not to be worried. We're not to be afraid. We're to trust in the Almighty God. Now, before you sit down, we do this around Faith City all the time. I want you to take your hands and throw out some blessings to some folks all around you. Just let them know you're a person that likes to bless somebody. Come on, bless them, bless them. Throw out a double blessing to somebody. Those of you watching, I'm throwing you out a double blessing right now in your house, in your home, and on your family in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Can somebody give the Lord another praise God right now? Oh, we're so happy to see everybody here this morning. My goodness, what a great day to be in the house of the Lord. And we're excited to have all of you that watch faithfully online. It is a joy to be together in the name of Jesus. Well, we're getting ready to come to that point of the service, very important part of the service, where we receive the opportunity to show the Lord how much we love Him, how much we appreciate Him, and we thank God for His provision. How many by the raising of a hand could say, you thank God for everything He's given you? Can you raise your hand? How many thank God you could get up out of bed today? Are you thankful? Are you thankful? Oh, I said, are you thankful? I got a call early this morning to pray for a lady that's bedridden. Thank God you're not bedridden. Can I hear a praise the Lord today? So much to be thankful for, and sometimes the things that we take for granted. But the Bible says that everything we have comes from the Lord. Everything. Somebody say everything. Everything comes from the Lord. Your health, your strength, the job that you have, the ability to receive income, that all comes from the Lord. And the Lord says He doesn't want all of our money. He knows we have bills to pay and obligations. But He does say, I want you to put me first in your finances and in your money. How many have learned over the years when you put God first in anything, it helps in everything, doesn't it, when you put Him first? And so He says, when it comes to your finances, here's what I'd like you to do. The Bible said in Malachi 3, verse 10, He said, I want you to honor me. And He said, I want you to bring all of the tithe into the storehouse, that there may be meat in my house. God said, my house, my work, the gospel work needs provision. And He said, I want you to do that, whether it's here or you're watching right now. And He said, if you'll do it, why don't you watch me open unto you the windows of heaven? Watch me pour you out a blessing that there shall not be room enough to receive it. And I will rebuke the devourer for your sake. When we give God 10% of that check He helped us make, the 90% that's left will go a whole lot farther, because He said, I'll do three things when you put me first in your money. He said, first of all, I'm going to pour out a blessing. I'm going to bless you. Secondly, He said, I'm going to increase you. There will not be room enough to receive it. And thirdly, He said, I will rebuke the devourer. I will protect you. Today, I want to ask you to pray about helping the church, if you would. There's a large project that is ahead of us. And we knew this project would be headed our way because the church 7 days a week is open. Not five, not two, not weekends only, but literally 7 days a week, 24 hours a day, the gospel is going out of the address called Faith City Family Church. This big project that we've got to begin to take on one part at a time, one area at a time, is, of course, our parking lots. All of the snowstorms, the blizzards over the years, all of the wear, the tear, the revivals, the events, the special days, and the thousands of souls that have rolled through these doors. How many believe if we take care of God's house, He's going to take care of your house? Can I hear a loud amen from somebody right now? You might say, well, I think I need some work, Pastor, on my driveway at home, and I need to get some sealing and a seal coat and some patches done. Listen to what I'm going to tell you. Write it down in your Bible. If you will help the house of the Lord, He's going to help your house and your house and your house and your house. Today, I'm going to ask if there might be a few folks that could join the pastor to begin this project. Going to have to take it an area at a time and then begin to discover what needs to be done. But how many know we've done a lot of things around here over the years? How many believe God will help us get this done? Can I hear a loud amen? Come on, somebody encourage the preacher right now. Hallelujah. I'm believing right now to be 15 people. I 14. Said, Pastor, I know it takes resources to get this started. Let me raise my hand with you. I'll sow the $100 seed to get this off the conveyor belt and get us going. My hands up. I'm stepping out of the boat by faith. I got to make a couple calls this week and make two appointments on it. And all I can do is walk on the water. Is there somebody else would raise up your hand and say, I'll give today $100 seed to help begin to work on the church, the parking areas. Is there a couple hands might go up? Yes, Lord, help me, ushers. It's there's a hand. God bless you. There's another one. Praise the Lord. And there's another one. Praise God. Thank you, sister. So, yes, up there on the platform, there's another one. And I'm trying to keep my count, folks, but I might be a little off. Are we at five, ushers? We might be at five, I think. Let's see, are there a couple more? Just a couple more that'd be six, praise God. And could there be someone else? There's one of our ushers, seven, praise the Lord. Pastor, don't you get tired of these? Listen, it's part of doing the Lord's work. Remember a few years ago, we had to get all new roofs on the building. That was really something to walk through. But how many thank God He got us to the finish line? Give me an amen right now. You don't run from the devil. You run to the challenge. Might there be a couple more people? There's another usher right now. Thank the Lord. There's another sister. Praise God. And if you can't do the 100 today, could you do? There's another one. Hand went up. Well, thank God Almighty. Thank you, Jesus. Maybe you could do 50 or whatever you could do. And before I pray, I want to look. Is there another hand went up? I missed it. All right. I'm going to look in these cameras. There's a lot of folks. You can't get out to church. And we're your church. Would you do your best to help us today? I need a lot of you to say, let me do my best. And I decree and declare, like we've done a lot of big projects here over the years, how many believe we're going to make it to the finish line? Is there an amen from somebody? Hallelujah. Come on, give the Lord a shout right now. The devil is a liar. I will not run from the challenge. Now, Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray that everybody here will know, and I guess we're kind of reminded by the events, the world events that we're seeing, that Jesus is coming again. And the two things that will always remain is what we did for God and what we're doing for others. Lord, I pray that everybody will say, Pastor, praying for the church, praying for you, and I'm going to do my best today to help out. Because, yes, when everybody does their best, whether here or watching, we'll get to the finish line. In Jesus' name we pray. Thank you, Jesus. Somebody raise your hand and praise God. The devil's a liar on this. In the name of Jesus, amen and amen. I want to ask our wonderful ushers that I appreciate so much to come and put an envelope in everyone's hand. And while they're doing that, I want to look into these cameras and share with our online church family how to give your tithes and your offerings. Ushers, would you make sure everybody gets one? I'd be so grateful. I'm believing for a miracle today. Online, you can give your tithes and offerings by using text to give if you like, 302-455-2820. Or some are using the Cash App. It's all safe and secure. $FaithCityFC2, lower uppercase, doesn't matter. Or maybe you'd like to download the app, the church's app, on your Apple or Android device and give that way. Still, so many go to the website of the church, faithcitynow.com, and click donate. And to all of you that like to write your checks and send them by mail, the street address of the church is 179 Stanton Christiana Road, Newark, Delaware, 19702. To every one of you here, I want to look to every section of the sanctuary and respectfully say thank you for what you can do to help us on this. And to all of you watching, a respectful thank you as well. I'll be back in just a few moments. Thank you. would like to ask the ushers to prepare to come. And Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray a special prayer of dedication over the tithes and the offerings to not only share the gospel message, but to take care of the house of God, what many refer to as holy ground, the place of prayer and worship. Lord, today, not only to those that are here, we thank them so very much, but to those that are watching right now, that together we make a difference, together we reach people, together we get it done for the Master Jesus Christ. So we dedicate all of this today in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen and amen. Praise the Lord. Thank you, ushers. As you take your time, we appreciate you so very, very much. And while they're doing that, to those that are watching, if you'd like to connect with us, you'd like information on the church, or you might want to join, or you have a prayer request, you can connect with us by simply texting that word connect to 302-214-5773. Just because you're not able to be here in person doesn't mean we can't walk this life together in faith. You can use the QR code as well. And I'm going to ask our ushers to help me in just a moment again about a very special event that has to do with housing in our community. But while they're getting ready to do that, I invite you to join me every Wednesday from 7 to 7:30 for the virtual Bible study. I'm sitting at my desk. It's 30 minutes of the Word of the Lord. And our theme for April are the habits, is the habits of happiness. That's our theme. This Wednesday, the 17th, our topic, how to be happy no matter what's going on in your life. And we're very excited about Saturday, May 4th, just around the corner, 9 a.m. to 1 p.m., an organization by the name of NACA, which stands for the Neighborhood Assistance Corporation of America, a national nonprofit community home ownership and advocacy organization, in cooperation with this ministry, is presenting the Home Buyer Workshop. NACA is the largest HUD-certified organization in America, helping people to become homeowners. Now, listen to this. NACA's home ownership opportunities require no down payment, no closing costs, no fees, below market fixed rates, and no perfect credit needed. I want the ushers to come, if they would, to the front. And if you'd like more than one flyer, they're happy to give you one. But listen, I believe God can take you from renting to owning your own place. This could be a door that you might want to walk through. So please take this special invitation. Take more for your family and friends. Saturday, May 4th, it is 9 a.m. till 1 p.m. right here at Faith City Family Church. And I believe it's going to be a great day of empowerment, a day to remember. And as our precious ushers are serving you, I want to make an announcement about Reach Gospel Radio, and they'll be helping me again in just a moment. But Reach Gospel Radio has been blessed to win, not over the years, one stellar award, but to God be the glory, nationally recognized. The Reach Gospel Radio has won two stellar awards. And so we're in the running, can you believe it, for our third stellar award. Isn't that God is amazing? And so I'm asking our ushers, if they would, they're so busy today, but they're doing a great job, to bring these other little flyers, I'll call them, to the front rows of the church. And if you would, ushers, to come up front and begin to pass them out. Folks, we want to ask you, if you would, to vote for Reach Gospel Radio. Many of you listen to it, and would you take this little information paper? You can use the QR code, and we only have, listen, till the 17th to be able, I believe, to vote. And I'm looking on here. Does it say it on here? Vote, yeah, now through the 17th. And so if you could make sure you vote for us, take a screenshot of it and share it with your family and friends. They can vote as well. You never know what God may do. He may give us another year of amazing favor as one of America's favorite gospel music radio networks. And don't forget, baptism is coming the 28th of April. If you'd like to be baptized and Holy Communion as well, just bring a towel and a change of clothes. So we're just excited about what God is doing here at the ministry, and we cannot do it without you. Our theme for today, and I love this theme, the amazing power of God's love. Some of you may remember that old hymn of the church. I remember it. When nothing else could help, love lifted me. How many have ever felt the power of God's love in your life? How many ever felt the power of love from another human being? Somebody, they didn't have to love you, they didn't have to go the extra mile, but because of the power of God's love, your life was changed. Our message today, the amazing power of God's love. Now, towards the end of the message, I've got something special I'm going to share. But ushers, could you help me one more time? Because I think I might see a few visitors here today, and I could be wrong. But musicians, as you continue to play, I'd like to ask at the early service this morning, if you're visiting the church, would you be so kind as to raise up your hand right now if you're visiting? As you continue to play, brothers, I request it. I'd be very grateful. Could you give me some music? Thank you so much. If you're a visitor, would you there? I thought I saw a new face over there. Would you raise your hand if you would? Anyone else? Every visitor here, if it's just one, means the world to us. We're honored to have you. So I would like, if you raised your hand, would you stand to your feet right now? We want to give you a big hand today. Well, come on, would you give our dear friend up here? I'm going to get to know her after the service. Praise the Lord. Amen. Give her a big praise the Lord. We want her to come back. Amen. That is so, so awesome. Thank you. And dear, if you fill out that card while I'm preaching, and I'll be in the back. We have free refreshments and our ministry tables back there. Give me that card. Present it to me completely filled out, and we have a gift for you today. Our theme, the amazing power of God's love, and our message today is entitled, The Amazing Power of God's Love. Let God love through you. I have a question. How many believe that God has some people he wants to love on through your life? Can I hear a loud amen from someone? God wants to use you to say that one word, to do that act of kindness. Or somebody may think they have no value. They may not want to live anymore, but God uses you to change their life. Our opening verse for the message today, the amazing power of God's love, let God love through you, is out of Matthew chapter 22, beginning with verse 36. Which is the most important command? Jesus replied. Well, he said, love the Lord your God with all your heart, soul, and mind. This is the first and greatest commandment. The second most important is similar. Love your neighbor as much as you love yourself. When we open up the pages of the Bible, did you know that the Word of God says that there are three laws of love in the Bible? Thank you so much, musicians, for your ministry. We appreciate it. And what are these three laws of love in the Bible? Well, let's look at law number one. It says that the best use of life is love. In other words, if you're going to make life count, don't be just self-focused, but be others-focused. And the Bible says that when we say yes to law number one, the best use of life is love. Well, why is that so important? The Bible says love validates my faith. There are a lot of people, they may shout, they may, praise God, and that's all important. We believe in that. But the Bible says that love validates my faith if I'm really what I say I am. In 1 John chapter 4, verse 8, it says, whoever does not love does not know God, because God is love. When somebody's hurting out in the community, in the world, it's the power of God's love that's going to grab their attention. Not how loud we preach, not how many times we run around the church, and that's all great and that's fine. But when you love somebody unconditionally, how many believe it's powerful when you love somebody that nobody else wants to love? It validates the faith. 1 John 4, 8. Here's another verse on love validates my faith. 1 John 4, 20. If we say we love God but hate others, we are liars. For we cannot love God whom we have not seen if we do not love others whom we have seen. The more we love, the brighter our light shines. We're talking about the first law of love. The best use of life is love. Love validates my faith. Next of all, love integrates my life. Love, God's love brings people together. You see, when somebody has the real love of God, now people know how to charade it. People know how to do church. Many of us have been raised up in church, and we get all that, and the charade goes on. But when it's real love from God, unconditional love, it brings people together. How many know that Satan has come to divide us? He wants to divide us. He wants us to hate one another. He doesn't want us working together. But the Bible says in Colossians chapter 3, verse 14, love can bring people together. Love is more important than anything else. Colossians 3, 14. It's more important than anything else. It is what ties everything completely together. Oh, there's nothing like the power of God's love. The God kind of love will bring people together in the toughest of times. It will make walls come down. Division will go. But sometimes you got to mark those. The Bible said in Mark the 17th chapter, it says, mark those among you who cause rifts and divisions. We pray for them, but we don't have to be a part of that, do we? I want to look at somebody and say, let's work together. Come on, look over somebody and say, let's work together. That's the God kind of love. The best use of life is love. Love validates my faith. Love integrates my life. And see, love compensates for sin. Some of you maybe never heard that, but the God kind of love doesn't condemn people into hell. I've heard some preachers over the years, I'm sure they meant well. They meant well, but they were so hard. They had mercy on no one. I guess because I've been doing outreach for so long, when somebody is broke down, somebody is messed up, somebody is addicted, they don't need Pastor Hare to come along and tell them how sinful they are and how bad they are. They already know their life is a mess. They need some love from God. 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 8, love compensates for sin. Most important of all, continue to show deep love for each other. Now, I want us to read the next part out loud, these handful of words for love. Ready? For love covers a what? A multitude of sin. That doesn't mean we condone the sin, but it means we're patient with people. When somebody who has an addiction, they go back again, and they stumble again, and they go back to the same situation. We don't throw them into the trash can of life, but rather we love them, and we hang in there with them, and we pray for them, because except for the grace of God, it could be you or me in that condition. Colossians chapter 2, verse 14, about love compensates for sin. God wiped out the charges that were against us for disobeying his law. He took them away and he nailed them all to the cross. How many are glad today we're not perfect, but we're forgiven? Can I hear an amen? And we're talking about the best use of life is love. Love validates my faith. It integrates my life. It brings people together. It compensates for. It has patience with people as they're in their time of recovery in their life. And then love reverberates forever. I've done hundreds of homegoing services, every age, every circumstance, lives taken out immediately through violence. I've done funerals where the casket is only that long. I'm telling you, the thing that lasts forever, the thing that people remember, is the power of love. Love. Why do we believe this? 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 13 says that love reverberates forever. Of all the things that will last when you're gone is how you love God and you love people. Three things, let's read, will continue forever. All right, what are they? The Bible said faith is one. That'll continue forever. Hope will continue forever. And love will continue forever. Now, some might have thought that faith would have been the greatest, but it says the greatest of these three is what? Shout it to me. It's love. Love reverberates forever. In the same chapter, 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse number 3, it says, no matter what I say, what I believe, and what I do, I'm bankrupt without love. Though I speak with the tongues of men and angels, though I prophesy, though I give my body to be burned. Read that whole chapter of 1 Corinthians chapter 13. It says all of that means nothing if I don't have the love of God in my heart for someone else. The three laws of love. Law number one, the best use of life is love. Love validates my faith, integrates my life, compensates for sin, reverberates forever. And the second law of love says the best expression of love is time. Real love will take and make an investment of time. Time to show up. Time to cancel what I wanted to do, to rearrange it and get involved in the pain, in the drama, in the mess of somebody's life. How many really honest Christians today could thank God for that school teacher, for that mentor, for that friend, for that church member? They got involved and helped you out. Can you raise your hand? They didn't have to help you out. You didn't give them any money for helping you out. They just wanted to help you out. They invested in you. And when that person goes on in the afterlife, how many know you remember people like that when they're gone? Because it's like, they taught me how to read. They took some time with me. They didn't have to do it, and others didn't want to fool with me, but they said, you matter, and I'm going to make an investment in you. Real love will take an investment of time. Time to show I care. Time to get involved. To help someone along life's way. Now, what does the Bible say about that? 1 John chapter 3, verse 18. We must show love through actions that are sincere, not through empty words. That's why sometimes the church at large can be a little bit unpopular or ineffective, because, you know, the world sometimes may feel that we really don't love them. We don't care. We're too busy shaking down their sins and the imperfections. But how many know if somebody has a lot of hell in their life, sometimes you just got to keep loving until you love it all out of them. Come on, say amen right now. How many would raise up a hand and say you're glad somebody worked with you, loved you, hung in there with you when others thought there was no way you were going to have a future? Not only did God help you, but God sent people to help you. Galatians chapter 5, verse 6, the only thing that counts is faith expressing itself through love. Lining these verses up, Ephesians chapter 5, verse 2, live a life filled with love for others, following the example of Christ, who loved you and gave himself as a sacrifice to take away your sins. Jesus said, all I'm asking you to do is do what I did. Jesus said, I loved you when you were a mess. I loved you when you did the same thing five times in a row. I loved you when you acted ashamed, Mama. You don't want anybody to know you were one of those Christians. I kept on loving you unconditionally 24/7 because that's just how he does it. And how many believe when you just keep on loving, love always wins? Come on, talk to me. I said it always wins. It might take a year. It might take a decade. But I'm here to tell you love will win in the end. Keep loving that child. Keep loving that grandchild. Keep loving that person. Keep working with that young person that is really going through a struggle right now. Don't give up on anybody. Because everybody has hope because of Jesus. Our sermon here today, our message, the amazing power of God's love, let God love through you. We're discovering today the three laws of love in the Bible. Law number one, the best use of life is love. Love validates my faith. Love integrates my life to help bring people together. Love compensates for sin and mistakes. It keeps on loving. Love reverberates forever. It really never dies. The second law of love is, it says, the best expression of love is when I give my time. You matter not only to God, but you matter to me. And if you want God to know that you love him, it helps when you give your time to the Lord. Come on, say amen, somebody. When you give your time to him, others never have time to give their time to the Lord, but you love him so much. God, I'm going to give my time. I'm going to change my schedule. Lord, I want to build your kingdom. And then law number three says this, the best time to love. Thank you, Brother Ron. I appreciate it. Amen. Now, I'm going to go back to my point here. The best time to love is now. The best time is to not say, someday I'm going to give her a call. Someday I'm going to call him up. I want to encourage him. Someday I'll send a card in the mail. But the best time to love, somebody shout, now. Come on, say love right now. The best time to love is now. Now, the reason I'm so aggressive on that point is because of what the Bible says. Galatians chapter 6, verse 10, whenever we have the opportunity, we should do good to everyone. Sometimes people will keep putting off, well, I know I should do that. I know I should pick up the phone. I know, and all that kind of thing. But the best time to love when God puts it on your heart is right now. Ephesians 5:16, use every chance you have for doing good. Proverbs chapter 3, verse 27 and 28, whenever you possibly can, do good to those who need it. Never tell your neighbors, wait until tomorrow, if you have the ability to help them right now. 1 Corinthians chapter 14, verse 1, eagerly pursue and seek to acquiring love. Make it your aim, your great quest. The best time to love is when somebody talked to me. The best time to love is now. I'll never forget, it was years ago, I was asked to preach a funeral, and many of you know where this is, in Newport, Delaware, the little town of Newport. There's one funeral home there. And I think the name has changed, but somehow I got the time a little mixed up, so I was there an hour early. Didn't realize it. And I pulled up. Of course, I didn't see many cars. I'm thinking, well, okay. So I go in there so I can meet with the undertaker and so forth and so on. And when I go in there, no one is at least in there. Maybe a couple of the workers were upstairs or downstairs or something. But no one but me, it seemed like, was in that funeral home. And I looked in the room, and there was the person that was laying there. But there was a young lady talking to the older lady in the casket. And I'll never forget it because nobody was. So I just stood there and watched. And it's like, wow, she's having a serious conversation with this person. And I just listened, and she began to open up. She began to cry. And she looked down into that casket. And she began to say this. And then finally, I figured out, I connected the dots, what it was.
she kept, at the end, she said, "And Mom, I know I should have called you. I know I hadn't talked to you for a long, long time." And she wept and she cried, and it seemed like she could not be consoled. And she walked out the door. I couldn't get to her in time, and she left before the funeral ever happened. And the relatives told me later, saying, yeah, that was her one and only daughter. She had a son, she had a daughter, and the daughter ignored her for years, broke her mother's heart. And I learned something. You better tell mother you love her while you can. You better love while you can. Like the third law of love is, the best time to love is now. Yeah, but she hurt my feelings. Yeah, but she did this. You know what? Sometimes we need to get over ourselves. Is there two amens from someone? We need to get over our hurt feelings because, you know, I watched her when as she left that funeral home, she seemed like she was just had the weight of the world, and I'm sure that she did because I'm sure the devil tried to torment her. All you had to do was call your mother. Couldn't you let her know? Matter of fact, I found out later on, the mom didn't know where she was. She had just run off and didn't know if she was dead or alive. Went to her grave not knowing if her daughter was alive. I'm here to tell you the time to love is right now. Right now. How many by the raising of a hand could say, you know, I got some people I think I need to love on. Come on, raise your hand up. Let the devil see it. I said, let the devil see it. Brother Robert, we could do some music. I appreciate it right now. It just raise that hand up. Yeah, God is right now talking to you. Yes. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Look at all these hands. God is speaking to hearts today, saying the time to love is right now. Oh, keep that hand up. He's going to give you the grace. He's going to give you the words. Maybe might be somebody you haven't talked to in a decade, but the time to love is now. Call him anyway. Eat humble pie. Yeah, well, I told him I'd never talk to him again for what they did to me or what they did to my child. If God says to reach out, you better reach out before it's too late. He might use your reach out to get their soul saved. He might have you to talk to them because in a matter of days, they could breathe their last breath. And God wanted you to talk to them before they left. Oh, let's pray, Father, in the name of Jesus. I just want to thank you right now, Lord, that loving really isn't that hard to do. It's not really that hard to tell somebody that, hey, I'm sorry I haven't talked to you in a while. Just want to tell you that I care about you, that I love you. And even though they might say some things that may not be all that kind, we've got the peace in our hearts that we did the right thing, that we did the God thing, that we did what the Lord wanted us to do. Lord, right now I pray for relationships that have been strained. If you're going through a strained relationship, just raise up your hand. And many of you watching, maybe you haven't talked to that loved one, that sister, that brother, that family member. God, we pray about strained relationships. It happens in every family. But God, you're bigger than that strained relationship. Yes, the three laws of love. The best use of your life is to love people. The best expression of love is to give some time, and the best time to love is right now. So God, give us all the grace and the strength to do it. In Jesus' name we pray. Oh, thank you, Jesus. When nothing else could help, love lifted me. I was sinking deep in sin, the song said, far from the peaceful shore, very deeply stained within, sinking to rise no more. But what happened? But the master of the sea heard my despairing cry. From those deep waters lifted me. Now safe am I. Love lifted me. How many by the raising of a hand could say you're so glad that love lifted you today? Come on, give the Lord a praise right now. Somebody wave your hand and give God a praise right now. Father, we want to thank you for it in the name of Jesus. When nothing else could help, yes, it was love that lifted me. Oh, yes, Jesus. As Brother Robert's playing that old hymn, I haven't heard that one in a while. when nothing else could help. It was love that lifted me. Now, before we go, saints, I know I announced, I think it was 4 Sundays ago, ushers, if you might get ready to help me just one more time, ushers, if you could. I announced about 4 weeks ago that God had given, opened up a door. We were able to get FCC approval. This is a miracle, with a limited time to do it, to expand the coverage of the Reach Gospel Radio Network by 1.5 million, not 150,000, but 1.5 million more people to come under the coverage of Reach Gospel Radio. How many know that's a miracle? Can I hear an amen? That is nothing but a miracle. And listen, we're living in the last days. We need to reach people while we can. And I said, in order to get this equipment and get this upgrade and the HD transmitters and all that's required in today's technology, I said we needed 125 people who would make a pledge. And we're not receiving an offering. We already did that. We took care of that earlier. But would make a faith pledge of $50 a month for 12 months to help us, because we're running out of time. This is the final Sunday that we have to do this, because we have to do it by a certain amount of time or we'll lose the permit to do it. Well, Sister Angela, one of the church secretaries, I said, revisit all the numbers, and here's where we are. Out of 125 needed, we only need 20 more. Can we give God a praise? I said, we only need 20 more people, 20 more people to get this done. Now, this is the final Sunday, and I wanted to know if we could see a miracle happen in the... Now, remember, this is not giving anything. This is a faith pledge of $50 a month for 12 months. And for those that do that, I felt in my heart to put something together to say thank you to all of you that do that by faith. We're going to have a thank you dinner on Sunday, April 21. That's next Sunday, a big catered dinner here on the lower level of the church. I mean, all the trim is going to be great, great fellowship. And then we're going to reserve you seats. People are coming from the 4-state region to see this lady, Leandria Johnson. I've never seen, it's been years since I've seen advanced response this strong. And I've been at this a minute now. But how many believe God could give us a miracle today? Just 20 left to go, and we really need to do it today. It's a pledge. So I want to ask the ushers to come up to the front, my blessed ushers, if they would. And would somebody raise up, when you raise up your hand, Leonard's going to change that 20 to 19. I'm believing that we can do it today. 1.5 million more souls. Would you raise up your hand right now, say, you know, I'll help. I know the Lord's coming back soon, Pastor. There's a hand. There's another hand. We're down to 18. God, well, I'm believing that today we're going to get it done. Hallelujah. Yes. Is there another hand? It's a pledge every month. You just fill out this card. They have a pen for you. But to think we could, there's another hand. There's another one, Leonard. Praise God. Amen. Might there be one more before we get ready for the benediction here? I know the devil done want 1.5 million more people. When Brother Dan told me this, I almost fell out of my chair. I said, you mean us? We're approved? He said, yeah, but you're going to have to raise some money, and we got to get HD equipment. I said, bring it on. You know me, I'll jump out of the boat and walk on some water. Is there one more? He'll get us to 15. And it will do what? There in the back. Can we get God a shout right now? We're down to 15. Praise the Lord. I said, praise the Lord. Brother Williams, you pray for me that today we're going to get it done. Now, those of you watching online, you can do it too. They're going to bring up on the screen right now how to do it online. You go to reachgospelradio.com. I pray Brother Leno will be able to put that up on the screen for you, that you can help us reach that goal today. Yes, there it is. So, beloved, can we stand to our feet? I see Sister April's got these delicious free refreshments ready for us. I see that our special visitor, I'm sure she got her card filled out. I got a gift for her today at the early service. And when you go in the back,
if you should desire to say, I would like to join the church, when you do, I'll present you on that special Sunday with this beautiful certificate, and it enables you to be able to be an honored member here of Faith City Family Church. You want information? You can go to the visitors or membership table. You want to be baptized? You go right to that baptism table, and they'll take care of you. Would you stretch your hand out towards me right now? Oh, I'm so thankful that you came today. So grateful. And remember, the time to love is now. I've been at this a minute. Listen, God will get you through hassles with people, headaches, foolishness going on that you shouldn't be dealing with. Just keep your heart right and love through it, and God will put it all together. So now I'm praying, as your hand is stretched out to me, I'm praying that you're going to love like you never loved. I pray you're going to call somebody, send a card as the Lord puts it on your heart, and as you do it, you're going to be blessed. So now may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you. May the Lord lift up his countenance on you and give you his peace. In the name of God the Father, Jesus the Son, and the Comforter who is the Holy Spirit, I pray you'll be blessed in your coming in, and as the Bible says, as you're going out, I pray you'll have tremendous favor this week, that doors will open that no man can shut, and whatever resources you need, God will not only provide them, but he'll do it in abundance. In the name of God the Father, Jesus the Son, and the Comforter who is the Holy Spirit, amen, amen, and amen. How about a loud praise to the Lord right now? Beloved, I'm in the back. We're back here to take your visitor card, your pledge cards, and fellowship with refreshments.